iodine's incredible cancer-fighting properties. Now in part two, I'd like to specifically talk about the thyroid and how your thyroid gland must have iodine in order to function properly. If you want to regain health and live optimally, you have to heal your thyroid. It regulates your metabolism, and thyroid hormones regulate bodily functions like your heart rate and even your blood pressure. You know what the scary part about all of this is? So many people in the United States have thyroid problems. According to the American Thyroid Association, an estimated 20 million people in the United States have some type of thyroid disease. Now, in part three, I'll go into more specific detail as to why I think this is. But one of the major problems that we have as Americans is that we are not getting sufficient iodine in our diets. Your thyroid will not function properly without iodine. Okay, so iodine is part of what is considered the halide family. Chlorine, bromine, and fluoride are essentially like iodine's toxic siblings. That's what I like to call them. Now think about this. Chlorine is in our swimming pools. Bromine has been put into a lot of our food products over the years. And fluoride is obviously in most of our toothpaste. Now I understand that these halides have been used for different reasons, but that does not erase the fact that they can be extremely harmful to our bodies. Now, when you do not have enough iodine in your thyroid will accept these toxic halides or siblings in its place, causing multiple health problems. When you do have adequate levels of iodine in your body, it protects your thyroid from accepting these invaders. In addition to protecting your thyroid from chlorine, bromine, and fluoride, the helpful non-radioactive iodine that I'm referring to actually can help to protect your thyroid from the harmful radioactive iodine that comes from radiation. So just like the thyroid will accept chlorine, bromine, and fluoride in its place, it will also accept radioactive iodine unless you're giving the thyroid the non-radioactive iodine that it needs to survive. Natural non-radioactive iodine will significantly help to block all of these invaders from being absorbed. A physical manifestation of an iodine deficiency in the thyroid is goiter, which is when the thyroid gland is enlarged. But understand that some people may not show any outward signs of a thyroid disorder, and yet they still have one. So even if your thyroid appears to be normal to you, you could still have a thyroid problem. The thyroid needs iodine to create the T3 and T4 hormones, which are necessary to ensure that your thyroid functions properly and to regulate your metabolism. According to Dr. Brownstein, as iodine levels have decreased, cases of thyroid disorders such as hypothyroidism, Hashimoto's disease, Graves' disease, and thyroid cancer have continuously increased in number. He said, and I'm going to quote this, "After 20 years of practicing medicine, I can state that it is impossible to treat thyroid illness if there is an inadequate level of iodine in the body, and this includes autoimmune thyroid disorders." So I hope I've made it extremely clear to you guys just how important iodine is to the health of your thyroid. Your thyroid needs to be taken care of at all costs. Check out part three to find out why so many people in the United States are iodine deficient. And I'm going to tell you what I use to ensure that I'm getting sufficient iodine. Nothing but peace and love. Thank you guys so much for watching. And remember, you are not alone. We're on this journey together. Until next time.